29-week pregnancy update. I am 11 weeks away from being 40 weeks pregnant. I did have Jane at 38 weeks, so we are definitely less than 3 months away from meeting baby Jackson, and I'm just so excited. But let's get into what was going on this week as far as symptoms. I have been feeling pretty good, actually. If you can tell, I get out of breath really easily. I'm starting to feel large, and like sitting on the couch and trying to get up is difficult. You know, just starting to get big and just feeling big. Fun little fact, I have gained 20.4 pounds since my pre-pregnancy weight. My pre-pregnancy weight was the same exact as it was when I was pregnant with Jane. And at 29 weeks with Jane, I had gained 20.4 pounds as well. So exactly the same amount of weight has been gained with Jane's pregnancy and this pregnancy, which I think is just crazy. Obviously, you know, as the weeks go on, that might change, but I just think that that is just crazy. Also, I went to my sister-in-law's wedding dress fitting last week, and they had a measuring tape there. I have a measuring tape, but I don't know exactly where it is at the moment, so I haven't really been measuring. But I took the advantage and measured myself when I was there, and I am exactly 39 inches, which is also the same as 29 weeks with Jane. So I am just going right along, I guess, growing the same. I do feel like I'm carrying differently, but I can't really tell in pictures. I also meant to go back and look at my blog that I had when I was pregnant with Jane to see what symptoms I was having at 29 weeks and around 29 weeks with Jane to see if the symptoms were any the same or different. I do know that I had a lot of bloody noses with Jane. I don't know if that's TMI, but I had a lot of bloody noses. We also lived in Texas, and there was a lot of allergies there, like seasonal allergies, like cedar and stuff like that. And obviously I was pregnant in a different season with her. So maybe that contributed to the bloody noses. I have no idea, but I haven't had that yet. And I also had to end up taking my rings off with Jane, but I can't remember what week that was. I do feel like they may be starting to get a little bit tight this time, but not having to take them off yet. And I can't remember when I took them off with Jane, so we'll have to go back and check, and I'll update you guys next week with that. I know comparing pregnancies, you know, pregnancies are totally different, but I just think it's crazy that the same exact weight gain, same size and everything so far. I have still been sleeping really good. I haven't had to get up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom. Although if I do have to shift positions in the middle of the night, I sometimes feel like I may could go to the bathroom, but the thought of getting up out of bed is like torture, so I'd rather just lay there and then I end up falling asleep and not getting up to use the restroom. So at least I don't have to go that bad to actually get up. I have noticed that I have been super duper hot at night. It is still technically winter, I guess, and we still have our heat on in our house, and we set it to 70, and we also have a fan that blows on us at night as well, and usually that's enough to allow me to cuddle up in my blankets. I like to have it cold in the room when I'm sleeping so that I can cuddle up in the blankets. And I also feel like if my legs are out, somebody's gonna come grab my legs. So usually I like to have my legs under the blankets, but I wake up in the middle of the night with all of the blankets off and I'm like hot. I don't know how they got off of me. Obviously I took them off at some point and I fall asleep with them on. So when they are off, I don't want to put them back on because I'm like really hot. So I might be having like hot flashes or something's going on. Nothing to like keep me awake at night or anything. So that's good. I have noticed that Jane is getting very clingy to me and wanting me a lot more than normal. She has always been super duper independent since the day she was born. She never really liked cuddling and always just wanted to do things on her own. And she would go to Chris if she wanted Chris. She would go to me if she wanted me, but was never really like attached to one or the other or anything in particular. So I don't know if it's just the phase that she's going through since she just turned two. Maybe this is something that she would do normally, even if I wasn't pregnant, or if she's starting to notice that something might be up. I don't think she knows that she's going to have a brother. She knows baby Jackson's in my belly. She knows baby Jackson has a room here. His toys are out, his car seat's out, and she knows that it's baby Jackson's. But I don't think she really understands what's going on. So I'm not sure if that's exactly what is happening. But she is very clingy, and it's actually starting to worry me a little bit, especially when he does get here. And if I'm having to hold him or breastfeed or, you know, tend to his needs, if Chris is not here, it's going to be very difficult. And also, even when Chris is here, lately she's wanting me to do everything. She wants me to come when they take a bath. She wants me to play with her. She wants me to hold her. And I'll be doing the dishes, and Chris is right there to play with her, and she doesn't want to have anything to do with him. And she wants me to play, and it's just a very difficult, even right now, when I don't even have a baby. So I'm a little bit anxious for that. I feel a lot better that we got Jackson some clothes. I have a haul video that I already put up, and I already have another haul filmed for you guys. I've been getting a lot of things for him, and I feel a lot better about that. Now we just need to get to the bigger things. I need to get another monitor. I need to get a double stroller possibly, and maybe that is it. As far as getting ready for him though, we still need to set up the swing, set up the bassinet and all that as well. And with 3 months or less than 3 months left, I feel like we should start doing that sooner than later. Only because we do have a lot going on in the next few months where we will be out of town as well. So I have my next doctor appointment on February 24th. So I don't really have anything else to update on until I go there, I guess. Jackson moves around so much. I know after 28 weeks, you're supposed to do a kick count at night and in the morning. And I don't even feel like I need to do a kick count. This kid kicks me and moves around and wiggles around so much more than Jane did. I kept thinking maybe I'm smaller this time and he's the same size as Jane was around this time, so maybe I'm just feeling it more. But since I know that I gained the same exact, and my belly is the same exact size, I'm a little bit confused. Maybe he's a bigger baby than Jane was. I don't know, but I feel him all the time. And I remember with Jane, I did do the kick counts a lot because I didn't necessarily feel her moving around a lot. So that is something that is reassuring. Just always feel him moving around and not have to worry about anything as far as that goes. But I will show you guys my 29-week belly, and then I'll see you next week. Okay, so this is with the shirt on. I'm wearing my pajama pants today. Definitely still an outie belly button, and you can kind of see it through the shirt sometimes. But that's it. I hope you guys have a wonderful week. I will see you next week with my 30-week update. I cannot even believe it. And I hope you guys liked the video. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and subscribe to my channel if you're not already. And I'll see you next week. Bye.